Mailboxes drip like lampposts in the twisted birth canal of the Coliseum. Rimjob fairy teapots mask the temper tantrum. Oh, say, can you see 'em? Stuffed cabbage is the darling of the laundromat. And the sorority mascot sat with the lumberjack. Pressing, passing, stinging half-synthetic fabrications of his time. The mouse with the overbite explain how the rabbits were ensnared. In the skinny, scanny self-thrash, the apothecary diplomat inside the three-eyed monkey within inches of his toaster oven life. In my mind, I'm half blind. My inner ref is mostly deaf. I'm smell impaired, if you care. My sense of taste is wasted on the phosphorescent orange peels of San Francisco axe-encrusted frenzy. So let me touch you, let me touch you, let me touch you, let me touch you, where the royal jelly gets made. Cholera tourist singers bringing weeds and social clingers, hangers-on and fancy flingers to the dress ball. Mushrooms and bowling pins, stovepipe hats and other things I can't recall from juvenile hall. We're so unlucky and stuff. Woodrow Wilson never had it so tough. Dairy Queen and Vaseline and Maybelline, Paul Bunyan and James Dean. Allegory agencies of Pre-Raphaelite paganry and Shenandoah tapestries compared with good mahogany, collapsing the undying postcard romance. The feline perspicacity by the university, that night I held a paucity which you deemed common courtesy. I wasn't what you thought I'd be. I shouldn't have invited you to dance in my tree. I'm halfway free, and in my chair, one quarter there. In my dream, 1/16th cream. In the coffee of the courtier, of the sycophantic assistant to the king. So let me touch you, let me touch you, let me touch you, let me touch you, with a roar. You're a liar.